Welcome to the QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool video tutorial. Use the controls below to fast forward, rewind, or stop at any time during this tutorial. During this video, we will go over how to access the QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool, how to search and browse knowledge articles pertaining to the various CMS program-related questions, how to submit a question to the CMS support team, and how to request a list of recently submitted questions or request case information. The QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool can be accessed from the main QualityNet homepage by selecting the Help option on the top right and selecting Q&A Tool Main Page beneath the Question and Answer Tools section. You can also enter the web address cmsqualitysupport.servicenownservices.com/QNET_QA in your web browser. The QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool provides self-help information in the form of knowledge articles for the CMS Ambulatory Surgical Centers, ESRD facilities, inpatient hospitals, outpatient hospitals, inpatient psychiatric facilities, and PPS exempt cancer hospitals. The knowledge articles are stored in knowledge bases according to their respective CMS programs. There are several ways to access knowledge articles. You can perform a search by entering keywords or a phrase in the search bar in the center of the QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool homepage. A list of matching articles will display beneath the field. If you see the article you wish to view, you can select that article on the list. Otherwise, select Enter on your keyboard to view the complete list of matching articles. Once you've located the article you wish to view, select that article in the list to view its contents. If it is the first time that you're viewing the article that day, a disclaimer message will display on the screen. Review the disclaimer and select Continue to view the article's contents. At the bottom of the article will be options to rate the article, print the article, or email a copy of the article. You'll also have the option to perform another search by using the search bar located on the top right. This will allow you to search for articles within that knowledge base. If instead of performing a search for articles, you prefer to browse articles within a knowledge base, you can use the Browse Program Articles dropdown and select the knowledge base you wish to browse, or you can return to the QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool homepage and select the Browse button, which will display all of the knowledge bases within the QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool. The top-rated and most viewed articles out of all of the knowledge bases will display in the center of the screen. If you would like to view articles within a specific knowledge base, select the drop-down beneath the Program Knowledge Bases field and select the knowledge base you wish to browse. In the Category section, there will be a list of all of the categories for that particular knowledge base. If there's a plus sign next to a category name, it means that it contains subcategories, and to view those subcategories, you'll need to select the plus sign. To view articles within a category or subcategory, select the category name, and the articles will display in the center of the screen. Okay. To view the article, you'll simply click the article's name. If you need to navigate back to a previous page or knowledge base, you can use the breadcrumb navigation located at the top of the knowledge base. Select the link to the location where you would like to return, and it will return to that page. If you have a question for which you cannot locate a knowledge article, Use the Ask a Question feature located on the toolbar, or select the Ask a Question button on the bottom right of the Quality Q&A Tool homepage. On the Submit a Question to our Support Team page, you'll need to enter your first name, last name, the email address where you want to be contacted, and then you'll need to confirm that email address by re-entering it in the Confirm Email Address field. If you would like to receive a phone call from the CMS support team, enter your phone number in the phone number field. In the question details section, select the program to which your question pertains. Then select the topic related to your question. The list of topics that's displayed in the window will vary based on the selected program. In addition, some topics or programs may require additional information. If so, those fields will appear on the page. Enter a short description of your question in the subject field. Then provide the details regarding your question in the Please Describe Your Question section. When entering information on the form, do not include personally identifiable information, also referred to as PII, such as your date of birth or social security number. Also, do not enter protected health information, referred to as PHI, such as medical record numbers. Once all information is entered on the form, perform the reCAPTCHA verification and select Submit Question to submit your question to the CMS support team. To request a list of all of your recently submitted questions or details about a specific case, place a request via the My Questions page, which you can access by selecting the My Questions option on the toolbar or by pressing the My Questions button in the lower center of the Quality Q&A Tool homepage. On the My Questions page, you'll need to specify the type of request you're submitting. If you would like to receive case information for a specific ticket, you'll select case/reference number of a question and enter the corresponding reference or case number. You'll enter the reference number if the ticket was submitted prior to October 21st, 2019, using the format referenced above. If the ticket was submitted on or after October 21st, 2019, you'll enter the case number according to the format listed above. If you would like to request a list of your recently submitted questions, you'll select email address used for questions on the dropdown. Then you'll enter the email address that you used when you submitted your questions. Once the information has been entered, perform the reCAPTCHA verification and select Submit to submit your request to the CMS support team. To provide feedback on your experience using the QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool site, select the Site Feedback button on the right side of the page. Verify that your name and email address are displayed in the window, and select your level of satisfaction with your experience using the site. Provide any additional information or feedback in the Enter Feedback Here section, and select Send to submit your feedback to our support team. We greatly appreciate your feedback as it helps us improve our site and user experience. For additional information or support using the QualityNet Quality Q&A Tool site, contact the QualityNet Service Center at 866-288-8912, Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. until 8 p.m. Eastern Time, or via email at qnetsupport@cms.hhs.gov.